Okay, for number 13, we have two transformations going on. And so we're going to walk through these. And just remember, anytime we have a transformation, a change on the outside, that affects the y. And in this case, this function, both of our transformations are on the outside. So we're going to multiply it by 2 and then add 1. So that's going to be a vertical stretch here by 2, and then we're moving it up. It's a moving it up 1. Generally, you're safest to go ahead and follow order of operations. So what happens first in this thing? Well, you find your y value, you multiply it by 2, and then you're going to add the 1. So let's do our transformation in that way. So we're going to take, again, our y coordinates, and we'll walk through the steps. So I've got negative 2, negative 4. Negative 2, negative 4 is 1 point. And that's all I have to figure out is these three. And you'll see the 0, 0, at least under multiplication, won't change. But when we add to 0, it will change. So we're going to put that there. And then we've got the point 4, negative 2. And again, everything's happening on the outside, so it's only going to affect the y. The only time we change the x is if there's something inside the parentheses, which, you know, we'll probably see in the next step. So 2 times the y. So we're going to do that again to each of the 3 points. It's the first step. Multiply by 2. So we get the new point, negative 2, negative 8. We get the point 0, 0 still, because 0 times 2 is still 0. And then we get the point 4, negative 4. The second step is we're going to add 1 to each of the y values. Add 1, add 1, add 1. So this is going to be negative 2. And since it's the opposite, we're actually subtracting. That gets us to negative 7. So that's, again, this point has been moved up 1 by adding 0, 0 actually does get affected. It becomes 0, 1. And 4, negative 4 becomes 4, negative and a positive. We subtract them, so 4 minus 1 is 3, and 4 is bigger, so it's negative. Okay, so those are our 3 points. Let's go ahead and switch it out. So we're going to have negative 2, negative 7 is going to be there, 0, 1 is going to be there, and 4, negative 3 is going to be there. So kind of a stretch, but also a raising it, okay? So let's go here with our Alex pencil. We just need to focus on the endpoints that we've plotted here. Okay, and then we connect them with a segment. Just remember the order we did everything in, and then connect them with segments. That's what's kind of cool. Okay, there's our transformation there. You notice just following order of operations, step by step, multiply the y's and then add 1 to it. Let's see what we've got down below. Let's clear that out. We're going to do some things with the x, but we're also still doing something with the y here. So we've got two things going on, and we'll do it by order of operations. Remembering order of operations, we do the inside first, right? Inside parentheses, and then multiplication. And this minus 1 on the outside is equivalent to multiplying by negative 1. Inside, what are we going to do? Well, we are going to subtract 4. So that's all that's going to happen. So again, we find our points at the vertices, at the ends of our lines, because then the lines will just follow the points. So we've got the point negative 4, 0. We've got a point negative 2, negative 4. And we've got a point 0, 0, one of my favorites. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is we want to subtract 4. Oh, no, remember, we're inside. That's right, right. We actually want to add 4. Whenever you look into the mirror, everything is backwards. So instead of subtracting 4, we're going to add 4 to each of these x values. It's the first thing we're going to do. So this becomes 0, 0. This becomes positive 2, negative 4. And this one becomes 4, 0. So what's happening is everything gets shifted this way to the right, which is backwards. So you think, oh, the negative would move it in the negative direction. No, negative moves it in the positive directions. Everything is going to shift over here. So we would get something that looked like this. And then 4, 0, right? Just a move over to here, okay? The next thing we're going to do is we're going to multiply all the y values by negative 1. So it's not x minus 1. It's really multiply. So multiply by negative 1, okay? So we come back here. Let's change colors for the next step. So we're going to take the y values and multiply by negative 1. And what that has, every negative value becomes positive, every negative y becomes positive, every positive y would become negative. So it's just going to change the signs on the y's. And so we're going to see this reflecting or flipping over the x-axis. So negative 1 times 0 is still 0. So we're still at 0, 0. This one becomes 2, positive 4. And this one becomes, well, 0 times negative 1 is still 0, still becomes 4, 0. So those points don't move. So when we're on the x-axis, they're not going to move. But this point down here becomes 2, positive 4. So it was a shift by 4, shift to the right by 4, and then a reflection. So let's go ahead and do that with Alex. So we plot our points. The Alex pencil. Oops. Let's see. Undo. Give me the pencil back, please. There we go. And then we put our segments together. Again, just connecting them in the order that they were, you know. So kind of follow the transformation as it goes through. And that's what it becomes, a shift and then a reflection. Two steps. All right. That's number 13.